music, worship the work of the late, great Quincy Jones. Among them, Frank Sinatra, who not only gave the fabled musician and producer the nickname Q, but also bequeathed him a ring bearing the Sinatra family crest when Sinatra died in 1998.
It got no grave. It either love you or roll over you in a Mack truck in reverse. There was nothing in between.
Quincy Jones was behind scores for some 30 motion pictures, along with theme songs for TV classics like Ironside, and Simps. Raise money for famine relief, a feat all the more remarkable considering a decade earlier he'd suffered two brain aneurysms so severe his doctors gave him only a 1% chance of survival. Just a little bit of soul. Loving friends had actually scheduled a memorial, a service that some 30 days after being stricken, the recovering Quincy Jones was strong enough to attend, to enjoy songs from guests like Marvin Gaye, Sarah Vaughan, and Ray Charles. Q, winner of 28 Grammy Awards, died last Sunday after living life his way.
When I look back, it feels like 200 lives, it really does. I don't waste any moment in life. I just, whatever's there, I'm interested in it. That's what living's about.
Quincy Jones was 91 years old. Marking a milestone, and luckily, she's in the mood to share. Who knew in 1982, when I published my very first book, Entertaining, that in 2024, I'd be standing here telling you about my 100th book, 100 of my favorite recipes with backstories and vintage pictures. Today I'd like to show you two recipes from the book that I think you'll find inspiring and easy, and like many of the recipes in the book, utterly delicious. We are going to show you how to make Alexis's chopped salad. And Alexis is my daughter, and Alexis is a vegetarian. Look how beautiful just the ingredients are. Green beans, fresh corn off the cob, chopped tomatoes, chopped cucumbers, chopped red onion, chopped yellow pepper and red pepper, chopped yellow string beans. These are blanched, as are the green beans. I still have to finish the purple peppers. All you have to do is cut this way into four pieces. It takes all the seeds out. You see that? That's a nice little hint. The reason the salad is so beautiful is that everything is cut up very neatly and nicely. Now the dressing is very simple, a couple tablespoons of olive oil, and then Japanese rice vinegar. Rice vinegar is a very nice pungent but sweet vinegar. I use a beautiful sea salt, about a teaspoon, and lots of freshly ground black pepper. Notice I'm doing it right in the mixing bowl. I find this is very nice, you don't have to dirty another bowl. Stir this around until you dissolve the salt. And taste it. Don't be afraid.
So good.
So now lift your vegetables right into the dressing. And now just give this a toss. A very nice way to present this is to line a gorgeous platter with the leaves of radicchio. This is an old porcelain platter that I found at a tent sale. I love this platter. Doesn't this look beautiful? This might become your favorite salad. And there you have one of the nicest, most flavorful salads you'll ever eat. This recipe might seem a little bit odd to be included in 100 of my favorite recipes, but it is one of my favorite soups, the buttermilk potato onion soup. And it is extremely simple and extremely peasanty. All you do is boil up an assortment of potatoes. I used one Peruvian blue from the garden, and here's a little red potato. Boil them very well, or steam them, until they are fork tender. Cut out every eye or any little defects as you're peeling them. The onions are very finely sliced and sauteed in butter and olive oil. A little bit of salt and pepper, and they are ready to add to the soup. This one gets a blue potato, a yellow potato, and a cucumber gold potato, and a nice helping of caramelized onions. The onions and the potatoes should be hot. And then, don't forget to shake your buttermilk, and then just pour the buttermilk around. Oh, look at the mess. You never serve with a dirty rim on your plate. To top it off, some sprigs of fresh dill. Just sprinkle fresh dill. It adds exactly the right amount of kind of Slavic flavor, I call it. I got this recipe, I guess my mom's mom handed it down to her. My mom's mom actually immigrated here from Poland in the early part of the 20th century, and this was one of their favorites. Have to have a little taste. This is the exact way that mom served it. Hi, mom. Really good. Well, I hope this book gives you really great recipes, inspires you to maybe even write your own cookbook, and I hope you enjoyed. I'm the master reptile.